before starting the video, please just subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for that. Then you can get all my videos on your fingertips and get your videos whenever I upload a new video here. So hey guys, just start the video. Let's start. Hello guys, welcome to FreeBirdsQ. This is our next project that is based on real-time text editor. In this project, I will make a text editor that helps you to build your web page and see the output in real time. In this project, I will use Python e-library that works as an intermediate between Python and JavaScript and other web technologies. So let's start our project. So to just build our project, we just need a Python file or our HTML file. So to make a Python file, I will make a Python file here, that is main.py. So, and another file is our HTML file. So for that, I make a folder here named as data. In this, I will make my HTML file as hello.html. So as my two files are created, so in Python file, I will make a code like this: import eel. Eel is a library. Eel.init that initialize your HTML templates. So our templates are stored in the data folder. We just allow this data, and as it allowed some extensions, I will show you. It shows only extensions like JS, HTML, TXT, STM, or XHTML. So in this project, I will use extension like JS or HTML dot HTML. So like this. And now we should make our function. That function that gives your output in your HTML file. So that function is @eel.expose. So as this, your function is exposed in your HTML file. Other function name is def, say hello. Python function as gives argument as yes, then print hello from this. So this function will give us output like here, Python world. I just read about this eel library from its own website. So it will give you a look like this. As you see, if you want to learn more, you can go to this website. It is eel library website. You can learn more about eel library and its functions and its more features like its modes, host, post, and many more templates, features, size, vision, geometry. Everything you might know about, it's on its official page. So this is our thing. And the other thing that I want to make it eel.start. It starts your HTML page with the help of Python. Our page name is hello.html. Hello.html. So it's like this. Now our this function is completed. Now for the HTML part, just do like this, HTML. The simple formality of HTML, that is making a header body tag. Our real time text editor. Our head part. So we just have to make sure our scripts are present in head. So for eel script, just have to make another script for eel. So you just don't have to put all your JavaScript links in this script line, because the eel script is separate from your all other scripts. So for this, just have to make sure that I will type here like that, field type. As you know, it is only type is text slash JavaScript, and the source is eel.js. So in this way our eel script is completed. So this should be separate. And now for our main script, for that I will make our function that works in Python, text slash JavaScript. So we just eel dot expose function say hello JS. So this function prints its output in Python. So if we call this function here like eel dot say hello JS and prints Python world, so it will print its output. And similarly we can make a function, because we make a function here say hello pi, so this we just expose it in here also. So for expose it here we can make a function say hello JS, because this function need to be exposed in Python, so we need to create it here like that. It can output on console.log hello from done. Now we just have to call our Python function eel.say hello pi, so it's a JavaScript, and our this function is say hello.js JavaScript. Our this function will print its output in the Python console, and our this function prints its output in the JS console. So let's run it, like make a body for first that body. Hello. Hello world. It's done. So I think it's done for all that. And now we just have to run this to make our script work. For that I will go to this folder. This is our Python script. Let's start it now. As we know again, I think I will save it here. Eel dot say hello JS Python world. Now we can run it now. Oops. It starts now. As you see that here comes the Python output, also the JavaScript output also. So it says hello from Python and hello from JavaScript also, both. It is the argument error. Let me just clear it. So it should be cleared now. So it says hello from Python world and hello from JavaScript. So this comes from here and this comes from here. So both sides can interact with each other. And if you see in this our text editor, you can see its console. console, you can see also hello from JavaScript, hello from Python world. You can also write in here. So this library should work as an intermediator. Like you can intermediate between Python or JavaScript both sides. So it is easy to build your applications with that. So now just we moved to our project, that is real-time text editor. So let's start with that. So this is our project, that is real-time text editor. In this I just add some CSS bootstrap in it, so to make it more attractive. And the main thing that works here, as you know, this is the eel script, so you can make it separate. This is our JavaScript. So this is the function, only this is the function that can make your text editor a real-time text editor. Because in this text editor, it can get your data from the text area and can write it down in the real time using this. So with the help of this, you can just make a one single text area like that. This is your text area. This is your frame where your output will come, and this is on key up function I will use. That when you press the key, when you just pick your finger up from the key, it refreshed, and your code will be in a refresh state. So this is just simple CSS or some bootstrap things. So this is easy for you to make. You just have to think about these line of codes, because in this line of code I just make a text area and iframe, and just apply it a function that I make here. With this simple function I can make a whole text editor with the help of this short function. And let's try to run this. So here is our file, we just have to run it. This is our file. We just don't need anything like that. We just have to start our index with this size. That can just run. I will show you my own website that I will make, on which I will upload my all projects here. So I will show you right now that. So you see guys, this is my short simple website that I will make with the help of this eel or bootstrap thing. So in this website I will upload my all projects with their YouTube, GitHub or working links, so you can check it out. I will make it online in some days. So let's start with our text editor. You can go, it's working. This is our text editor. So whenever you write code here, HTML, just go to body, then go for HTML. I just write here reverse view. It gives me output in the real time. If I just add some style here, color equal to red, so just make it in real time. Whenever you press a key, because as I show you, whenever you press a key, it does not show anything. Whenever you just pick up your finger from the keyboard, its output is shown. So this is the project that I will make with the help of JavaScript, Python and Eel. So it's a very beautiful thing that you can do anything in real time. I will also try to make a project with the code Python here. Just you can write a code Python from import Eel and apply the for loop here, so it can show the real working of for loop, that how for loop works in real time. It's like you can for loop for us and iterate over 5 elements. It can show how it iterate over 5 elements in real time, because whenever the you call the for loop, its whole working is visible in the real time here. So I am just working on that project and it will be completed soon. So I will show you that project also. So with the help of that, you can understand that the real working of your for loop, while loop, and your other things, your libraries, and many more things. So that's very important for us to understand the internal working of these functions or these libraries. So with the help of that, you can go for a very smooth programming career. So anyways, thank you for your time. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you like this video. Please like, subscribe, and share my YouTube channel so that I can get more motivation from that, and I can make more videos for you, and can make more amazing projects. So guys, our next project is simply based on this quick draw feature. As you know that what is a quick draw? Whenever you make
I see
a feature
circle,
like that, it
or
can
blueberry,
tell what is this.
Or apple.
It can say I see circle or moon or apple. So it can predict that what you want to draw. So our next project is totally based on this.
Sorry, I couldn't guess it.
Deep learning or any other Python libraries that I can get and make this project. I will surely make a clone of this project and make a video on that how I make this project, and each and every library I will explain to you that how this thing works and how you can make things your own. And so guys, please like our YouTube channel for that, and please click on the bell icon and share our videos more and more so that you can learn more and grow together. So thank you guys, thank you for your time, thank you.